I feel it's important to start with positional escapes in Brazilian Jiu Jitsu because that is really the foundation of building a good game. If you have good positional escapes, then later on as your game develops, you'll eliminate fear. And a lot of that fear comes from fear of losing a position, fear that you might not get there again, fear that you'll have to work just as hard to regain that position. But if you have a solid foundation in positional escapes, then say you're mounted and you go for an arm lock, you know, if you end up in an inferior position, that's okay. You can just get up off your back, put your opponent on their back, pass their guard, and then attempt the submission again. So, additionally, positional escapes really make the game a lot more fun. If you're suffering under somebody's weight, that is definitely not the experience most people are going for when they look at Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu. So once you're able to turn that corner and be able to reverse positions, then the game gets a lot more fun. Our first escape is a bridge and roll. It teaches you one of the most fundamental movements in Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu, which is the bridge, or upa, as it's known in Portuguese. TJ, please. TJ mounts me. I have to break down his arm, clasp my hands together, thumb over thumb. I pull his arm into my chest and then unfurl my hand. So one goes behind the tricep, another goes on the forearm. I use my elbow to push his heel down, block his heel with my foot before I bridge up and over, ending in good posture with my hands against his biceps. Again, clasp my hands together, pull his arm into my chest, lock it down and trap it. So one hand goes behind the tricep, the other attaches to the forearm. I use my elbow to push his knee down so I can trap his ankle, bridge up, over, and end in good posture with my hands on his biceps. The second bridge and roll technique is even easier because now they are telling you which side they'd like to get bridged to by where they place their arm. Just watch. TJ inserts his arm underneath my neck to establish a little bit more control. I comb my hair on that side, locking his arm into position. My right hand goes on his hip. I want my heel to touch his hip bone, and then I block his heel on the left side, same side that I'm blocking with my arm. From here, I bridge and then use my palm to also push his hip, push on the bicep, duck my head, push on the bicep. TJ establishes head control. I comb my hair. Hand goes on his hip. Block his heel. Bridge up. Push and push. Another method of escaping the mount is through limb entanglement and being able to use your legs. Eventually in Jiu-Jitsu, you learn to use your legs like your hands, and then you start incorporating other body parts like your elbows, your knees, and your head. Okay. So TJ has me mounted. My first move is to bring my forearm across his hips, clasp my hands together, and now I do a small bridge. Just enough to straighten my leg and turn my hip on its side. Once I'm on my side, I have a great range of motion with my leg. Now I can push his knee down, scoop his foot as my knee slides underneath. I'm guiding it with my elbow until I can pinch. Then my arm goes across. I move my hip out, insert my knee, make one more hip movement, and then I'm back in close guard. Forearm across the hip. Bridge up, fall on the side, drag the foot over, pinch, then the arm shoots across. I don't want him to put any more weight on me. Move my hip out to the side, use my elbow to open up his knee. Pull his arm as I move my hip
back into closed guard.
TJ's got me down, but now he has this rigid. Maybe he's wearing shoes, maybe this is just accessible to me. So, starts off the same, turn on my side. Now I actually scoop underneath that foot. Lift, pinch, and continue with my mountain scoop. So those are the required mount escapes, and now I'll show you a couple of others that you might find handy. It's important to have multiple escapes because eventually you'll be chaining these together. Against a savvy opponent, one escape is not going to cut it. You have to link them together to create space. Now please keep in mind that this is not good for mixed martial arts. This is only good for jiu-jitsu. Because you leave an exposure of your face as a target. So I take both my hands, put my palms on his hip bones, lock my elbows in. Now I use the power of my body to bridge up, insert my feet, and then end up in a butterfly guard position. This next mount escape, again, non-MMA safe, possible that you could use it, however, you're in a fairly vulnerable position for a second. So we all know that if I have one arm in and one arm out, this is not good, I could get triangle. But I'm much safer if I have both arms in underneath his legs. Say he's trying to get a high mount on me, well, I move both legs underneath, then I'm off balance to the front here, then turn over, and we can continue to pass the guard. Sometimes I have to bridge up so I can get my arms underneath. Once he's here, it's difficult for him to remain in this position. So I bridge up and then turn to the side, and then I can continue with passing the guard.